the rule of a rectangle. This began in the 40s with the renowned Jeep. I worked as an information specialist in the Army Material Command in the late 60s, and there were many items in the equipment inventory that were right up there in the public eye. One was the loss of life to rolling light utility vehicles known as Jeeps, circa 1968. And by rolling, I mean the operator would make sharp turns at speed and literally roll the vehicle. It was one of my busiest topics, right up there with nerve gas and disposal of nuclear waste. The modern vehicle, also called Jeep, seems to have corrected the problem, though the original Army model was never intended to be back then driven quickly around tight corners. But now, we had a problem back in 04. I haven't been on top of this lately. I wouldn't put it past the people involved to have, swept it under the rug. But then maybe they didn't. Maybe they cleared it up. I just haven't been following the news. But back in 04, when I wrote this article, there was a lot of SUVs that would roll on the highway. A lot of death and injury involved with this. And, the attitude was, oh, well, and then people began to get on their case. Was it an unsafe vehicle or what? Okay. Those type of contemporary vehicles using the chassis of a pickup truck to comprise the support of a modern sports utility vehicle have neglected the fact, did they do it on purpose, that these vehicles can be driven in excess of 60 miles per hour, and all it takes is a quick swerve and the structure will encounter a phenomenon of geometrical physics, which I call the role of a rectangle. The forward momentum of a rectangular volume will render the longest aspect of its shape into a square wheel. If a veer from its vector introduces enough forward momentum to its side, the advantage, how do you like my sign language? This one is stop. Okay, the advantage of the Jeeps circa mid-60s was its narrow wheelbase. That was the advantage. That assured the vehicle passage in narrow places when encountered, narrow places often encountered, finally got it right, by off-road terrain, or even getting around congested convoys of larger vehicles on paved or unpaved roadways. However, the operator had to know and be trained how to turn at 90 degrees with that vehicle. A right angle turn with narrow wheelbases must be attempted only after a deceleration to less than 15 miles per hour. The mistake was, dun, 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 only the facts, ma'am. Or it's not over till the fact lady sings. No, that was Tallulah. And good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are. Ha-cha-cha-cha. That's no banana, that's a banana republic. Yeah, when the bottom liners, you know.
Oh, it must be the bottom line is the main thing here.
Oh, the street dictates our bottom line.
You know, the bottom feeders, the you know, junk food down there in the sludge of the morass. And it was back in the early part of the 21st century here, the bottom liners flooded the high velocity highway with huge vehicles with off-road type wheelbases. And that was the mistake when they got in the game. I hate to say it, you know, I mean, at this point, it looks like the money isn't in how good your product is, but how good your lawyers are. At least that's how those guys play their game. Look. Got one of those pieces of junk, you can still get around, don't get me wrong. You know, buckle up your family and trust your children in one of those things. Just don't go driving your hustle-mobile as if it were a reliable piece of machinery, and you'll be okay. You know, that Ralph is getting too old to help you anymore. You know, Ralph Nader. Was famous when he managed to rescue us from planned obsolescence back in the 50s, where they were trying to design your car so it would become it would disintegrate after a certain amount of driving. You know, instead of being honest, building something to last. And you know what? I think they're getting away with that now. I'm not quite sure. But, you know, Ralph is not—he's getting too old to help you anymore. He's probably too busy out running for president, making sure helping the wrong president get into office. Hey, you know, I mean, they thought that North America, the United States, Motor City, man, back in the 50s, they thought, this is where cars are made. Only America can make a car. You know, blah, blah, blah. It's a total illusion. North and South America is the land of the Banana Republic. It's just that in the North, they managed to ban Nana and make it appear to be more legalistic. The banana of the United States, and it's up front exceeding presidentes, was the automobile. That was the big banana. The automobile. By the time the Japanese got around to making an honest car, the Americans had already been there as the fustest with the mostest, and damn, they could still sell those you-know-whaties, even if that one you or someone you know bought for $2.50 a month might be a Canadian make, with parts brought in from everywhere in the globe that could possibly be outsourced. Now pretty soon they'll have you assembling them yourself. Just like you have to do when you can't afford real furniture, you have to buy the stuff made of chipboard and assemble it yourself, you know. Ignorance is expensive. What can I tell you? And that's something we all have. You know, so you got to be prepared to pay the price. I drove my anything but Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry.
Them good old boys was drinking Orangtua and Quantro, saying, "This'll be the day that I diet." They were too chubby anyway. Yeah, I was at Aldemont today. The music died. But I saw the comet in the sky and got the heck out of there before Jumpin' Jack ever got on stage. It reminds me of ancient Rome, always emulating the Greeks. Hey, nothing wrong with the Greeks, it's just there is something wrong with lack of originality. That was Rome, always emulating the Greeks. No originality. Back in the 50s, New Rome, the USA, with their Motor City, were making the impression that the automobile was as American as apple pie. Apple pie. I mean, they had apple pie in France. It's just a different name. I forgot what it was. Anyway, they had cars in Europe before Ford ever went to work for Edison. That's right, he worked for Edison for a while. Or even before Ford ever left the farm. There was gasoline in Poland long before there was a rich Rockefeller. But, you see, that's the trouble with the imitators. They can only perfect. They cannot innovate. It's an indictment against the design capability of the big boys. You see, with those guys, they'll do anything to turn a profit. Well, am I wrong? How come they got away with it for so long? Oh, maybe you think it was an honest mistake. Whatever. I had to ride in one of those bounce buses once, and I told jokes. Because I knew I was taking my laugh in my hands. Now, okay, here is a probable approach to the geometry dilemma. Abandon the rectangle to compensate for the veer factor. The ideal is the U, but the practical is the spreading of a Y shape with a fork facing forward velocity. But, of course, remember, that's in concept only. That's in concept only. I can't afford to test it for free. You've got to perfect the design before you go and build one, let alone try to manufacture it. The first one to make a safe SUV out there gets rich enough to buy General Motors and Ford. Notice I said rich enough, not smart enough. They'd probably try to buy Mercedes instead. Number two would probably be smart enough not even to waste their time. And that's the story of the role of the rectangle, at least the beginning of it.